Josie Frame, teenage drama queen.
Well, excuse me if I don't act like Snow White.
Victoria Hudson, heartbroken, bitter.
You know that I have feelings. Forget it.
Whether it's your first time visiting.
Why don't we start at the beginning?
There's a whole crazy sequence of events.
Or you're an old friend.
Bay City called me back.
You're sure to fall in love with.
I think we're getting very close to a celebration. Woo!
Another world, next, only on SoapNet.
Dylan's
for seven.
So glad you're here, Amanda.
So am I.
I need you so much.
Evan.
Don't leave, Amanda. Not tonight.
I'm here to see Matthew.
Oh, come on, Lisa. What is your problem, Jake?
My problem, Jamie, is I'm not buying any of this.
What are you talking about?
She didn't come here to see Matt.
Yes, I did.
Hey, Jake, you better be careful.
Me?
Yeah.
Jamie, you're the one that's getting married on Friday.
Oh, and you think you have to remind me of that?
Yeah, I think I do.
I know what you're thinking, Jake, but you're wrong.
Okay, why don't you explain it to me? Why don't you explain why you come sneaking over here to see Jamie a couple days before he gets married to Vicky, huh? What is going on between you two?
Coast clear?
Yeah, all clear. Come on in.
Good. You know, I remember my first bachelor party. I couldn't have been more than 16. My favorite cousin was getting married.
What was that like?
Ah, those were the days bachelor parties were taken very seriously in those days. There was a whole bevy of beautiful girls popping out of cakes, popping out of all manner of places.
A bevy of beautiful girls.
Yes, but alas, those days are gone forever. We men have finally had to grow up, huh?
Yeah, right.
Still, it would have been interesting. Girl in a cake, interestingly anachronistic, like tipping your hat to the past.
Well, Amanda would have killed me if we'd done that.
None of us would have escaped unharmed.
Yeah, so it's lucky that our consciousness has been raised.
Extremely lucky. But I will always remember my cousin's party when my consciousness was at rock bottom.
Look, Mac, I was wondering, how is Jamie doing now?
Well, I'll tell you the truth, it's a little hard to read him right now. I think he's a little nervous.
That makes sense.
I just want so much for him and Vicky to be happy together.
Mac, I'm sure they will be.
You know, Sam, if Vicky makes him half as happy as you have made Amanda, I will consider it a marriage made in heaven.
Thanks, man. Listen, can I get you something to drink?
Thanks.
Let me see here. I've got some wine. This is Chardonnay, I think.
What are you having?
Beer.
Perfect.
A bottle or a glass?
Well, a bottle always seems colder to me.
You know something? If someone had told me before I married Amanda that I would be hanging out with Matt Corey, drinking a beer,
you would have said he was crazy.
Yeah, well, so here we are, talking about beautiful women and drinking beers.
All right, well, we have one very beautiful woman in common, the two of us.
Amanda.
To Amanda.
To Amanda.
Mmm, great. You know, Sam, I never did really adequately express how sorry I was about that whole art gallery mess.
Mac, look, I know Rachel was just trying to help.
She's a great admirer of your work. Both of us are. She won't do that sort of thing again.
Well, as my teachers always used to say, I am a hothead, so...
I prefer to think of it as artistic temperament.
Well, whatever it is, I let it come between me and Amanda for a while. But that won't ever happen again. Mac, I love your daughter. I won't let anything come between us ever again.
I'm sorry.
What for?
Ask you to stay.
No, I want to stay.
Well, I don't want you to think I'm some guy that can't...
I don't think anything. I'm your friend, remember?
The only one I got.
Maybe it would do you some good if you talked about her.
Who?
Your governess. What was her name?
Meg.
What was Meg like?
She was the sweetest, gentlest woman I've ever known. She gave me love. She gave me a sense of security. She gave me confidence.
Was it just the two of you?
Yeah, all alone in that big house.
Wasn't your mother ever home?
Well, it wasn't her fault. She just wasn't the type to be tied down to some little kid.
So you never had a real family.
I used to fantasize about my mom and dad being around Christmases together.
Oh, Evan.
But it's okay. It's okay, because Meg was there. She was there to open up my Christmas presents with me, and she'd meet with my teachers. You should have seen her the day I graduated from Penn.
Your parents didn't even see you graduate college?
God, I'm starting to sound like I feel sorry for myself. It wasn't that bad.
How could your mother just leave you like that?
She couldn't help it.
So your nanny was like a mother to you.
She was the only one I had. And I don't know how I'm gonna get through this thing.
I'll help you. You're back.
The lady's glad to see me.
Oh, I'm thrilled to see you. You're early.
Well, we finished the shoot early, so I thought I'd come back and surprise you.
Oh, I missed you a lot.
Good.
What?
Are you okay?
Why, do I look sick?
What is this with pills?
It's not pills, really. It's just aspirins.
Are you having headaches?
No, I'm fine.
Maybe. You don't even take aspirins. You don't take pills. Is something wrong? You didn't tell me?
It's Amanda.
What about Amanda?
She just got back from Chicago. Where she found lots of interesting little tidbits on Fanny Grady.
For the article?
Yeah.
Did she find out anything
about the baby? No. I thought she did. But she didn't. At least I think she didn't.
I'm going to talk to her.
No, Mitch.
I'm not going to let something like that upset you.
Look, I love you for saying that, but I really have to handle this myself.
Why?
Because I'm not Fanny Grady anymore. She never could handle her problems, but I can.
Look, I know you care about the Coreys.
Yes, that's true.
But I'm not going to let you be upset because you're too nice to mess up Amanda's big break.
I won't let this hurt me. I promise you. Okay? Come on.
So what did that guy want?
Guy? What guy?
I just saw someone coming down the hall. It looked like he came from here.
You're kidding.
I assumed it was one of the workmen.
Well, maybe it was Jason. I mean, he was in here earlier, measuring.
Has he been giving you any trouble?
No, he sort of grunts and grumbles, but I don't pay him much attention.
Jason is not one of my favorite people.
It's so funny that she would mention you saw somebody in the hallway.
What?
I've had the strangest feeling that somebody's been watching me.
The kids from
You've got one hell of
nerve, Jake?
You're not answering my
question. It doesn't deserve an answer.
I don't like what I'm seeing here.
Who gives a damn what you like, Jake?
Jake, Jamie and I are not about to defend ourselves to you.
Then there is something going on.
How dare you make accusations? You were in love with Vicky.
Vicky is my friend, Lisa. She always will be.
Well, let me tell you something, Vicky's friend. I am not about to go tiptoeing around so as not to disturb Vicky or you.
We don't have to apologize for anything, Jake.
Let me tell you something, Jamie. You hurt Vicky and you're
a... Just tell me how my coming over to see Matthew is going to hurt Vicky.
Why the hell, Lisa, would you want to come over and see Matt?
Matt and I study together.
Oh, get out of town!
I have just about had enough of you, Jake.
You expect me to believe this?
I expect you to leave.
You and Lisa can't keep your hands off each other. Like I said, Jamie, anything happens to Vicky,
get out of here! Get out!
What's going on
here? Matt, you and I will study somewhere else.
No, don't worry about it, because Jake was just leaving.
You know something? You guys can yell and act insulted all you want.
Goodbye, Jake.
Get out of here. Touch me, man. I don't like being touched. Get out of here, Jake.
Get out of here. Come on, get out of here.
You okay?
Yeah.
I just have one question. Why didn't I know any of this was going on?
Didn't know you were back, Mitch.
Now you do, Jason.
You know, Jason, just because I gave you a key, it would be nice if you would knock first.
Oh, hey, that's right. From now on in, I knock first.
Oh, listen, honey, I should call Tops just to see about the dinner crowd, all right? Excuse me.
Is that part of your contracting service?
No, she was feeling sick, kind of down. I thought I'd cheer her up.
If she needs any cheering up, I'll take care of it.
Whatever you say, Mitch.
So did you come to bring the flowers?
No, I just brought them. I came to work.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I mean, this is our job, and Frank Construction's gonna do it. We are gonna do it right. As my brother always said, Steve said, if it's a job that is worth doing, it is worth doing right. I think I should start.
You really send that?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Before you do, you know, Felicia's very kind, very thoughtful. Very open woman. Don't try to take advantage of her.
Yeah, I think she's delightful. She is a wonderful lady. I would never, ever think about taking advantage of Felicia.
That's good.
Good. Can I go to work? Thanks.
One other thing. Why isn't it that John's here?
John?
Well, I contracted with John to do the renovations.
Yeah, he's my partner. He does good work, and I do good work.
So if you're interchangeable, why isn't that he's here? Maybe every once in a while?
I think that's a good idea. Mitch, you and I ought to be friends.
Oh, yeah? How do you figure that?
Because we got a lot in common.
No, I doubt that. I doubt that very seriously.
Corey shafted you, and they shafted me. We should stick together, and maybe we can help each other.
I hope she knew how much I loved her.
I'm sure she did.
I don't know if I told her enough.
We never do. Maybe you want me to make you some coffee or something?
I don't know. I just can't believe she's gone.
I know it hurts now, but eventually the pain is going to get less and less.
What do you know about pain?
Look, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to make it sound like I knew what you were going through.
No. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that. I mean, you're being
no.
so nice and every...
You're right. I don't know. I've never lost anyone that close to me.
Well, you're lucky.
You're wrong if you think I've lived a charmed life.
You got a wonderful family.
I know that.
You got a great marriage.
That I almost lost through a misunderstanding.
You got a beautiful daughter.
That almost died if it wasn't for you. I'll never forget watching my baby struggle to breathe. The panic that I went through.
Yeah, you went really pale.
Then to get her back, have everything be all right. It really jolted me. I really realized how lucky I am. how much I have.
I didn't realize it affected you that way.
You gave me my daughter back. If there's ever anything that I can do for you.
Oh, there is, Amanda. There's nothing you can do for me.
I think watching a basketball game would be fun, but there might be a small problem.
What's that?
Well, our TV sits only 13 inches. I mean, it gets a great picture, but there's not a lot of it.
Well, after all, it's a camaraderie that counts, not to mention pizza.
Pizza? You want to eat pizza?
Well, what do you want? Four doves? Fancy finger food?
Right. We're talking serious male bonding here.
Absolutely. Double cheese, mushroom, and sausage pizza. How many should I order?
You really eat pizza?
It's not a pretty sight.
You know, I've been married to Amanda for a while now, but I never realized.
What?
Well, you and I are a lot alike.
You think just because I've got money that I can't enjoy a cold beer and a hot pizza?
Well, I know that was stupid.
They can be very comforting when life gets very rough.
I never thought of you as a guy who let life get to him. I always thought of you as somebody who's in complete control.
You know, I think I've been living on an ivory tower too much lately. We should do this more often, Sam.
Anytime, Mac.
Hey, you're too late, man. We've done all the planning.
Well, we haven't actually firmed up the topping on the pizza.
Yeah, but we're leaning towards sausage and mushrooms.
It's fine. Is Amanda around?
You kidding? This is just for the guys, man.
Oh, Jake.
What did you want to see Amanda about?
I just need to talk to her about Vicky.
Look, she's out doing research. I don't know when she'll be back.
We'll say, listen, we've settled all the important things, so I think my job here is done.
Very well done.
See you later, man.
Take it easy, Mac.
Yeah.
All right, something's wrong.
What? I just came back from Jamie's, man. Lisa showed up.
So?
I can't help getting the feeling that those two are still together.
It can't be.
Why not?
Because he's marrying Vicky.
Sam, that might be right for you or me, but I don't know about Jamie.
They wouldn't... Why would he be marrying Vicky if he was still with Lisa?
Simple. He marries her, she has the kid, he makes sure he's a legal father, and bang, he goes back to Lisa.
You two talk. I'm leaving.
Lisa, wait. Matthew, hold on. Matthew, let her go. Let her go.
Why?
She wants to be alone. Now, what's going on with you and her anyway?
We're friends, Jamie.
Close friends?
Look, the breakup was pretty rough on her.
And you think it was easy for me?
No, I'm not saying that. But Lisa's been at loose ends. We were going to be her family, and that all changed. You cut her off.
No one cut her off, Matthew.
Well, she thinks somebody did, and she needs somebody.
Matthew, I'm
not going to abandon her, Jamie. Maybe you can, but I can't.
These flowers really are lovely, Jason.
I'm glad you like them.
And I do feel cheered up.
That's because you got your old man home.
Yes, he does have that effect on me.
I will call John, we'll talk, and I'll have him stop by.
Good.
Okay. See you.
Hi, Jason.
Yeah?
Listen, this Corey grudge, just let it go.
Have you let it go, Mitch?
Yeah. Past is past.
I don't think you can ever totally escape from your past. I forgot, closet space. You haven't told me how much. The built-ins, I don't know how much space you need.
Well, I like to shop, so... Okay, I'm a shopaholic. I guess I need as much space as you can give me.
Okay, you got a bunch of cardboard boxes in there. You want storage areas for them,
boxes?
Or what?
Boxes? What kind of boxes? Shoe boxes?
Oh, boxes with letters or papers on them.
Jason? Those are very private.
Well, sure,
Look, I'll tell you what, it's been a long day. Why don't we just deal with that first thing in the morning?
Good idea. You guys have a nice night.
Right.
Stay with me for a while, Amanda.
I'm sorry. I don't think I can do that.
Okay.
Just Sam's expecting me.
Sure, go ahead.
I'll make you some coffee.
No, no, I can do that. Boy, that's never hit me like that before.
You really shouldn't drink when something like this happens. Why don't you lie down now, okay?
Yeah.
Head back.
Amanda?
Yeah?
Good for me.
What?
I said you're good for me.
Kevin.
Eight, nine.
Jamie would not do that. This thing between him and Lisa is over.
Yeah, well, it doesn't look like it's over to
me. You're dead wrong here, man.
I'm not dead wrong, Sam. You should have seen the way he looked at her.
I've seen the way he is with Vicky. It's real between them, Jake.
Man, Vicky would listen to anything he has to say. What if this is some way to take over the baby?
Look, Jamie would not do that. He's Amanda's brother, and I know him.
You're right, man. I'm probably just jumping to conclusions.
I think you are, Jake.
I've been strung out lately. The guy's got everything I want. He's got a great lady. He's got no money problems.
And he's got a baby on the way.
Where is yours tonight?
Ada's got her. She says she hasn't seen enough of her since the cafe's opened.
That must be nice, huh? I mean, you know, having a baby.
Yeah, it is nice. Tell me something. Do you play racquetball?
Where the hell did that come from?
Nothing. It's just that I got guaranteed court time for racquetball once this spa opens.
Oh, man. Yes, me. Racquetball sure seems like kind of a yuppie game, you know?
Ooh, yeah, that's a bunch of bull, too. Of course, you probably don't have the stamina for it.
This is starting to sound like a challenge.
There'd be no contest.
This is a challenge.
Mm-hmm.
One that you're gonna lose.
Ooh.
If I can ever find time.
Is that busy?
I gotta get a second job, man. Yeah, I got doctor bills, I got medical bills.
Yeah, I've been there. Money problems like that can cause a lot of trouble at home.
Yeah, and if Marley found that out, she'd straight away start pulling off her trust fund, you know.
And you don't want that?
Do you?
No.
I mean, the way I figure it, that money should be for Marley and the baby.
Yeah, I know what you mean. That's exactly the way I feel about Amanda's money, too.
Where is Amanda tonight?
She's a journalist, man. She's got weird hours.
Let me ask you a question. Doesn't that bother you? I mean, beautiful woman out there all alone.
I trust her. Besides that fact, she's made it very clear that she can take care of herself.
Stop.
I'm sorry.
You really shouldn't have done that, Evan.
You're right.
I want you to understand.
But you don't think I do?
I'm not sure anymore.
You just want to be friends.
Right. That's all.
That's okay.
It has to be.
I'm such a jerk.
No, you're not. You just had something terrible happen to you. I'm your friend. And so is Sam. You saved our baby's life.
Look, you don't owe me anything.
No, I didn't mean it like that. I meant... Oh, look, I've really got to be going. I'll see you.
That Sam's a lucky guy.
Make sure you get enough sleep.
The kiss, I was the drinking.
But just forget about it, okay?
No, listen, I won't mention it to anybody.
Take care.
Amanda. I'm sorry if I hurt you.
You didn't mean to.
I would hate it if we weren't friends.
We still are. You were lonely. I understand.
Thanks. I just don't think you should get too involved.
I'm not involved, Jamie.
A girl like Lisa, it would be easier for you to have feelings for her.
I'm not supposed to like Lisa?
You know what I mean.
Look, Lisa needs a friend, and I'm gonna be that for her.
I am not trying to isolate Lisa.
What are you trying to do?
I'm trying to look out after you.
What? By telling me to stay away from Lisa?
What does Josie think?
Now I can't be friends with another girl without hurting Josie.
I didn't say that.
Look, I like Josie. I probably love Josie. That hasn't been decided yet, but I'm not going to make any mistakes like...
Like Mom and Mitch did?
I just want to be careful.
Good. Be careful, Matthew. But don't use Lisa as a distraction.
That's a pretty cheap shot.
What is she then?
I can talk to her. I mean, she's different from the other girls I know.
Matthew, she's not a girl. She's several years older than you.
Come on, so what?
So I think the timing is all wrong.
Is that all you think?
Yes, what do you mean?
Maybe it's seeing someone else with Lisa that's bothering you.
Are you saying that I'm jealous?
What I'm saying is I don't understand why we're having this stupid conversation.
I just want to talk to my brother. I mean, we are brothers, aren't we?
Yeah, who happen to care about the same woman.
This is not just girl.
God, I love Jack Benny.
Jack Benny?
Funny, funny man, huh?
I thought you were thinking about us.
I think he had the right idea.
What idea?
Staying 39 forever.
No, honey, not again.
Do you remember when 39 seemed so ancient?
I thought you liked the idea of turning 40.
Oh, I don't mind the idea. It's just the reality I'm having trouble with.
I thought you said you weren't going to fall victim to this country's obsession with youth.
Sometimes.
What do you mean, sometimes?
Well, sometimes I fall victim and sometimes I don't, you know, like now.
I don't think you have to worry about anything, okay?
I wouldn't worry about it if... Well, if I thought I...
If what?
Well, if I thought I look 29.
Honey.
Well, Cass said I look 29. But of course he was kidding. I mean, he was, right? Well, of course he was. I know that. It's just that I was so pleased when he said it. And then, of course, I hated myself because I was so pleased, because it meant that I had no depth whatsoever.
Honey.
In fact, all I am is really very shallow, Mitch.
Honey.
I'm very vain. I'm very old.
Honey, Felicia.
What?
Don't interrupt me.
Okay.
You have the biggest heart of anybody I've ever known. For another, you're beautiful. You're beautiful inside and you're beautiful outside. You're generous to a fault. You're funny. You're kind. Not to mention sexy and wonderful.
Really?
Really.
Damn.
Damn what?
That's the longest sentence you've ever said to me since I've known you.
I have my moments.
I don't know why you have to always be the one to tell me this or that.
That's all right, I don't mind.
No, I should be one of those people that just knows.
But then you wouldn't be yourself if you just knew.
But half the time I don't even know who me is. Or who is it, who I is, or who is I,
honey,
or what?
Whoever you is. Just don't worry about it, okay?
You're getting so sweet, you know.
We're just starting.
You're right. We are just starting, aren't we? I mean, my 40th birthday is a new beginning, isn't it?
Yes.
I mean, this wonderful party that Brava is going to throw for me. I mean, it's an opportunity for me, isn't it? It's an opportunity for me to do all sorts of new things with my life.
That's
right. I mean, the hell with youth, right?
Right.
Mine was rotten anyway. I mean, the 40s. I'm going to embrace these 40s. I mean, this is going to be the most wonderful, the most productive years of my whole life.
And then you've got your 50s, then you've got the 60s, the 70s, the
80s. Honey, you don't have to overdo this. All right. This has been a wonderful time for me. You're right. This is a time when I have a wonderful job, I have wonderful friends, and I have a fantastic husband.
That's wonderful, you remember.
In fact, I'm going to use this rags-to-riches story. I'm going to let it be a purge to all the guilts and the fears that I've been feeling. I'm going to stop running away from Fanny Grady.
There you go.
I'm going to do it. I'm going to be able to face all those ghosts in my life.
I'm here.
I love you. I love you. You know that? And you're the reason that I can face everything.
If you want to be alone, just say so. I'll leave.
Mac, why wouldn't I want to see you?
Well, pre-wedding jitters. A lot of men want to be left alone.
Hey, look at these hands. They're solid as a rock. Come on in.
No butterflies? What?
Oh, there's only one or two or a thousand fluttering around there somewhere.
Hey, Mac, check this out.
What's this?
It's an old family picture album I dug up.
Look at that.
Can you believe that?
Oh,
who is that chubby kid?
Such a cute little boy.
I can't believe, Mom. Look at her.
If she's changed at all, it's to become more beautiful every year.
Yeah.
Oh, look.
Can you believe this? I remember this summer here. We all got poison ivy.
Yeah, I remember. Yes. Hey, there's Ada.
Oh, yeah.
And isn't that Stephen behind her?
Yes, it's Noah. Yeah. Right over here. There he is.
Your father was a very good-looking man.
Yeah. You know, what's funny is that those are the only two pictures I have of him. It's actually not funny. It's pretty sad.
You mean because you don't have more memories of him?
Well, I have memories. My kid's gonna have a lot more, Mac. I really wanted this marriage.
I'm very happy for you, Jamie.
I just wish that, Vicky and I could have gone about it the normal way.
Well, so you got a few things out of order. So what, Jamie? So what?
Lisa.
Yeah.
Matthew and I were talking about her earlier. He's pretty worried about her.
He's spending a lot of time with her lately.
He thinks that she needs protecting. From Vicky and me, I guess. Hmm. It's some pretty hard times.
I know that.
But I don't even have the right to say that.
Of course you do, Jamie.
Oh, Mac, it's Vicky and Lisa who've been the ones who've suffered so much.
You suffered too. And you behaved honorably. You behaved with compassion.
Boy, you don't know what good timing it is to hear that.
I couldn't love you more, nor be prouder of you, if you were my own son, Jamie.
Mac, I love my father.
I know that.
But no one could have been a better father than you have been to me.
Thank you, Jim. And you're going to be a terrific father yourself. I know.
Well, and I'm going to be there like you were.
I know you will be.
My kid is going to have everything, Mac. He's going to have a mother and a father and grandparents and a dog and a house and little baseball cards.
He's going to be a lucky kid.
You got any advice?
Well, let's see. You've got a great big heart. I think you might start developing a little thicker skin, though.
Thicker skin.
Yes, okay. Because there are gonna be times, I'll tell you, when that kid is gonna wound you very deeply. That kid is gonna cut you to the quick.
Did I do that?
Well, of course you did. You had to. You couldn't be a walking illustration of what your mother and I wanted for you, not if you wanted to be your own man. Now, could you?
Okay, I'll remember that. What else?
Well, let's see. There are gonna be some times, some very frustrating times, when you'll feel like you just can't get through anymore. They just won't listen. And times when you feel like you're just terribly dated. Times when you feel like you're the enemy. And then the times when you see them slipping away from you.
What do you do then?
You just love them a lot more, that's what you do.
Must be hard.
No, it is. But they'll also remember those marvelous, magical moments when, for no reason whatsoever, your child will turn to you and your child will say, I love you, Daddy. And then you know there's nothing on earth like that. And it's all worth it. Everything you've done is worth it.
Can't wait.
Your father would be so proud of you right now, Jamie.
Thanks, Mac. I hope so. I'll be happy if I can just be half the father you have been to me.
Let it go.
How to what go?
Come on, enough is enough. You're the big plan with Amanda.
Would you knock it off about her?
What are you saying?
I don't want to discuss it.
You're going soft on this deal.
And what if I was? What would you do?
What exactly happened here today?
I tell you, I'm just sick of the hating. I'm sick and tired of the hating. I want peace.
I don't believe I'm hearing you say that.
Well, I'm just not so sure about this whole thing.
Then you better get your, right now.
Oh, ruining more lives. That's worth it.
Amanda got to you. She really got to you. Is that it?
She's a kid. See, she's just a nice, gentle kid.
She is a Corey.
Yeah, well, I felt like scum. You should have seen me with the big crocodile tears lying my head off while she just sat there.
Yeah, she didn't buy your story, did she? That's it.
She's not like her mother.
She's just like her mother. She has a carbon copy of her mother. You don't get her first, she will nail you. You've forgotten what the frames have done for you? You've forgotten what the Coreys have done to you.
Glad you're here.
Where else would I be?
I missed you.
Okay, what's the matter?
Nothing.
You seem upset.
No, I'm just tired, that's all. Is Ellie asleep?
She better be. It took me an hour to put her down.
So I had to go with Dad.
It was fun. Your dad's got a great sense of humor. We had a good time.
Good, glad.
So how about you? How'd it go?
What?
How did tonight go?
Tonight?
Yeah, your interview with Felicia?
Oh, yeah, right. It was fine.
That's it? Fine?
What's wrong with that?
Amanda, look, you never discuss your work in one word. Hey, come on, what's wrong?
It's Evan.
What about Evan?
I went over to see him and work with him tonight. He was a mess. The woman that took care of him when he grew up died today. Oh. That's all you're gonna say is, oh?
What do you want me to do, Amanda? Cry for the lady? I don't know her.
I think we should see more of him.
Why? Because his nanny died?
Because he's all alone. He needs friends.
What really happened tonight?
He really fell apart.
And
I helped him. I saw a totally different side of him.
Look, Amanda, relationships, friendships like that can get kind of complicated.
So what's wrong with reaching out to somebody?
Look, I didn't say it was wrong. I just said
if we can't share our lives with one other person, what kind of people are we? Come on, Sam, how can this hurt us?
Amanda Corey, you just may be my downfall.
Are you tired?
Exhausted.
Ready for bed?
Yeah, why don't you go in ahead and warm up the bed for us?
Okay.
Okay.
Miss Witta.
Oh, hi.
Hi, I was looking all around for you.
Why?
Well, I was worried, you know.
Oh, I'm okay.
Listen, can you sit down for a minute?
Matt, you don't have to come riding to my rescue.
I'm not. I just thought we'd talk for a little while.
Sure.
So, are you okay?
Yeah, hey. Jamie and Vicky are getting married, and I'm getting on with my life.
Meeting new people?
Trying to.
Come on, someone like you shouldn't have to try.
Oh, you'd be surprised.
Come on.
Well, it's not that there aren't a lot of men around, it's just that most of them aren't my type.
What is your type?
No, I like men who are caring and gentle and have a good sense of humor.
Of course. What?
Nothing. I was just thinking.
About what?
About how well you and I get along. We wouldn't want to spoil that.
No. Spoil that.
Hey, thanks for looking out for me.
Sure, no problem.
Oh, I guess I better get going.
Hey, I'll walk back with you.
Oh, okay, sure.
Okay. You look kind of cold. You want my scarf?
Oh, thanks.
Dive into Melrose Place, weekdays at 6, only on SoapNet.